Hello, and welcome back to Data Science Wednesday. My name is Tessa Jones. I'm a data scientist with Decisive Data. And today we're going to be talking about machine learning. It's a really big buzzword right now. It's all over the place. Today we're going to talk about how it applies to data science and really break it down into two general categories: unsupervised machine learning and supervised machine learning. The basic difference between these two actually has to do with the data that we're inputting into the model and our objectives going out. Unsupervised machine learning is when we have unlabeled data. We have a lot of variables, but we don't necessarily know where they fall in terms of what our objective is. Supervised machine learning, on the other hand, is when we have a series of variables and they are labeled. So for example, maybe we have a data set about flowers. We have lots of variables that describe the flowers, the features of the flowers, and we have it labeled. We know that it's species A, B, or C. What we really want to know is, what we want to be able to do is take something like this and then take another data set that isn't labeled, that has the same variables, push it through a decision tree to decide which species it is. That's the real goal here. So this is the end result of a machine learning supervised decision tree. During this basic process, when it was doing the machine learning, it iterated through all the different variables and which flowers it was specified as. And it really optimized where these nodes are located in the tree and what these values are that distinguish between the different species and the different nodes. It iterates through this many, many times until we've really optimized, or we feel really confident about what species we're designating based on the features that we're inputting into the tree. So another example of machine learning, supervised machine learning, is regression. In this example, we're going to talk about sleep and happiness. Because we all know that the less sleep you get, like if you don't get very much sleep, you're generally not very happy. But also if you get too much sleep, you're really not that happy either. Here we have on the x-axis number of hours of sleep, and on the y-axis we have a happiness scale. So here you don't have very much sleep, you're not very happy. You start to get happy the more sleep you get, and then you reach a point where the more sleep you get, the less happy you are. So a good use case for this would actually be, like, let's say you're a physician and you want to be able to predict how happy a patient will be when they tell you how much sleep they get on average. What we want to do is create a function from the data that we have. Each point here represents a person in our supervised data set. We took a subset of people and we said, okay, how much sleep do you get and how happy are you? We have a whole set of data here that tells us exactly that. That's what each point represents. And we want a line here to designate, to basically represent that data, so that when we're a physician and a patient comes in and says, I'm getting 12 hours of sleep, well, that one's kind of obvious. Maybe your happiness scale would be really low. But let's say it's 6 hours. They want to be able to push it into this function and say, well, your happiness scale is probably going to be around a 7. Good news. The way that this works is it iterates, the way the machine learns this is it draws lines iteratively through these data points in hopes to best represent the data. It does this as many times as we tell it to, and then eventually it gets to this line that is the optimum representation for this data. So now let's go into unsupervised machine learning. So to give a little bit of a recap, unsupervised means that it's unlabeled. We don't really know what we're dealing with. One good example of unsupervised machine learning is clustering. This is used a lot of times in marketing campaigns when we want to do customer segmentation. We want to understand customers, how they are, so that we can have targeted marketing campaigns. Let's take an example with cereal. So this is the final result of a clustering unsupervised machine learning algorithm. And we have a cereal. We want to know something about our customers that buy cereal. So we're going to look at two different variables. We're going to look at fiber and we're going to look at sugar. So on the x-axis we have fiber and on the y-axis we have sugar. Up here, this is probably where I belong, where I like a lot of fiber but I also like a lot of sugar. We call these guys the high fivers. In the middle here, we have your average Joes. They kind of like a medium amount of sugar, medium amount of fiber. And then we have your lean Larrys, where they want to keep their sugar content as low as possible. If this was a supervised example, we would have all of this information and this data would already be labeled. But we don't have that. We had to make this up, not knowing how these different groups would fall. The way that this kind of worked and iterated through, so you see this line here is really what designates between these two groups. And it went through a clustering algorithm many, many times, and it basically redrew this line. So maybe the first time it would belong here, and these two guys down here might belong to the high fivers. And maybe the next time it was drawn like this, where these guys were considered the average Joes, and these guys were considered the high fivers. And eventually it found an optimum place to place that line so that we can best represent these two different groups and then target them in a marketing campaign. Another really great use of machine learning is what's called dimension reduction. This is largely used as a tool to help data scientists reduce the number of dimensions that we're using in our models so that they can be more timely and effective. A lot of times we can have lots and lots of variables and we'd like to reduce them down. One way to do this is to when things are really obvious. So sometimes you just know that data isn't really going to matter. So if we have the same problem here or thing here where we're trying to identify what's the best corollaries to segment customers in terms of buying cereal, we might know that they really don't care about what caking agent the cereal has in it. So maybe we'll just throw that out because we know that it doesn't really matter. However, we might know that dye really does matter. So maybe we can take three different colors of dye. Maybe we have blue, yellow, and red, and we can make these three variables down into two variables. We hold the same amount of information, but we're holding it in two variables rather than three. And basically, the way that the machine learns the optimum way to represent these three variables is these are the two new variables that we're going to create, and it basically positions these in different locations in this three-dimensional space until they have the optimum representation of these three different kinds of dye. That's the general overview of machine learning. We're talking about unsupervised and supervised machine learning, where we have labeled data to work with, we have unlabeled data to work with, we can do clustering, dimension reduction, regression, and decision trees. There's lots of other things that we can do with data, with machine learning and data science. And thanks for joining me today. My name is Tessa Jones with Decisive Data.